Good morning, friends. In last lecture, we have studied superposition principle. Example 1.6 is based on superposition principle. See, consider three charges Q1, Q2, and Q3, each equal to Q, at the vertices of an equilateral triangle of side L. What is the force on charge Q placed at the center? See what is question, understand? It is equilateral triangle A, B, C. Three charges are placed, Q1, Q2 and Q3, each equal to Q. You have to find what is force acting on charge Q placed at center, name G. Okay? One simple question. Force acting on G is due to another charges. That is due to A, due to B, and due to C. So according to superposition principle, first of all, we will find individual forces and then we will add them vectorially. For equilateral triangle, AG, this distance, BG, and CG, these three distances are same. For equilateral triangle, AG is equal to BG is equal to CG is equal to R, we are assuming. Okay, now see, force acting on G due to A. Force acting on G due to A. These all charges are like charges. Force acting on G due to A is repulsive force. Repulsive force means away. See in which direction? It is centroid G. Force acting on A is in this direction. It is F G. Now, force is vector quantity. For vector quantity, direction is important. So, how to take direction? We are taking this centroid on origin. So, let it is positive x direction, it is positive y direction, it is negative x direction, and it is negative y direction. So from this figure, you can say Fj is in negative y direction. So how to write? See, Fj, we know equation, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0, constant. Charge on G is Q, charge on A is Q. So it is Q, Q upon Ag. Ag is equal to R, so it is R square. It is magnitude. Now how to write direction? Fg is in negative y direction. Negative y direction. What is unit vector in negative y direction? Minus j. Clear? Now next. Force acting on G due to B, Fj. Force acting on G due to B, Fj. Chalo, first of all, write down magnitude. 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0. Charge on G is Q. Charge on B is Q. So it is Qq. Again, Bg. Bg is equal to R. So it is R square. Now what is direction? C. Force acting on G due to B. Repulsive force on the line joining two charges in this direction. It is Fg. It is Fg. See, direction of Fgt is easy because you can say it is directly on negative y axis. But what about Fgt? It is simple. You have to resolve this factor. See, for equilateral triangle, this angle is 60. So this half angle is 30 degrees. So this angle is also 30 degrees. If you resolve this Fgt in two components are in this direction. X component in this direction and Y component in this direction. x component is along negative x axis, y component is along positive y axis. Then how to write unit vector? See, how to write unit vector. As this component is along negative x axis, we can write this as minus cos 30 I carry. Minus cos 30 I cos 30, because this actually makes angle 30 with this component, so it is named cos. Cos 30. Why minus I? Minus I is unit vector along negative x axis. Y component is along positive y direction. So we can write plus sine 30 j. So it is unit vector along FG. Okay. Now force acting on G due to C. Force acting on G due to C. FGC. Right magnitude 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0. It is Q upon R square. Yes, this is it. Okay. Direction. Force acting due to C on G. It is repulsive in this direction. In this direction. It is FGC. Again, 60, 30, 30, two components, one component along positive x direction, another component along positive y direction. Both components are in positive direction. Then how to write plus cos 30 I plus sin 30 g. Fj, Fg, Fgc. Three individual forces. Now according to superposition principle, resultant force acting on g, Fg is equal to, it is Fga plus Fg plus Fgc is equal to. See? Magnitude. Equal. Keep going. 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 qq upon r square. Come. In bracket, here it is minus j. Here it is minus cos 30 I caret plus sin 30 j. Then plus cos 30 I caret plus sin 30 j. Minus cos 30 I plus cos 30 I cancel. Is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 qq upon r square minus j. Sin 30 1 by 2. So it is plus 1 by 2 j. Sin 30 1 by 2. 1 by 2 j. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 1. So minus j plus j is equal to 0. Means it is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 qq upon r square 0 is equal to 0. Means resultant force acting on charge placed at center is 0 if charges placed on vertices are equal.